My latest creation, folks. Well, this was a biggie, folks. This one was the longest build I've ever worked on. It took me about 2.5 months to create this baby. But I went with a 1/8 scale Revell Trans Am model kit. I paid big bucks for the body just to get the body and the interior, but these kits are becoming rare and they're getting quite pricey. But you get what you pay for. And it was worth it. Turned out awesome. Now let's start with the interior. Let's take off the T-tops so you can get a little bit better view of the interior. Very detailed interior. I had a Trans Am like this one years ago. I was always fascinated with the dash that they did them. Stainless steel aluminum dash that looked beautiful. So I tried to create that in this one. Of course, you got the NOS bottle and a fire extinguisher just in case. 5-port safety harnesses. Now, I built the roll bar out of heavy gauge copper wire. That was a bit of a challenge. The vents on the side, I cut those out and put metal screen in behind it just for more detail. Of course, my headers are all heavy gauge copper wire, copper wiring. The side exhaust, copper tubes. I put a wire brush in my Dremel one evening when I was in the mood and did some artwork on them. Created these designs in it, kind of to give it the look of the spun aluminum dashes in these Trans Ams. But turned out good. And let's give you a shot of the where all the work went into. Here's hours of work. The vents, I cut those out and put metal screen in those also. But the engine, I know the GM guys are gonna freak, but I did put a Chrysler 426 Hemi motor in it. A lot of detail. The valve covers. Every bolt you see in here where a bolt would be in a real motor, I drilled it and put metal screws in it. Got a coil down there with the minus and plus wiring. Distributor all wired. All these screws are everywhere. The pulleys, the blower, And I've got a fuel pump down in here. You can't see it at the moment, but with a copper wire or tubing that goes all the way up to the carburetors. The 2 4-barrel Holley carbs. A lot of detail work in here in the engine compartment. Just trying to make it look as real as possible, folks. Real as possible. The brake master cylinder has copper tubing running to that also for the brake lines. And got a wired Delco battery here in the corner with the plus and minus cables, of course. It's set up with a metal gear servo for steering. You'll see in a minute, it's super smooth and quiet. Beautiful, huge aluminum wheels. I painted the centers gold, just like all the Bandit cars were. I call this in my Bandit on steroids. It turned out wicked. And of course I had to put my Florida plates on it. Come on, camera. There you go. Even have an audio system stuffed up in here, along with the brushless motor. You can see the ESC one, and you can control the volume on the audio, and you'll hear that here in a second. All right, let's get this baby fired up for you. Switch it right back down the back for power. And I've got headlights. And of course, taillights. And here's one of my favorite parts, the sound. Love that audio. Well, I hope you guys like this one. Thank you so much for checking it out. And I've got plans on my next build, but I can't tell you what it is yet, but it's gonna be another 1/8 scale car. You guys have a great day. Till my next one. Thank you, all my subscribers. I really appreciate you guys. And the belt on the blower is real rubber. Hope you enjoyed this. And again, you guys all see my email address. Get in touch with me. All right, till the next one. Love building these things.